Then I remember Fernando Vargas. Fernando Vargas, in one of the fights, he drops his opponent and then goes up to him and spit in his face. They find him. I don't know how much they find him. 15, 10, 15. They find him. The commission find him for spitting in his face. Fernando said that was the best. That was the best $15,000, you know, that he spent because he spit on that guy's face. So it was for him. It was, you know, it was worth it. So maybe for Conor, it's also worth it. 150, maybe no big deal for him.
I gotta tell you, Fernando Vargas was the shit.
Fuck yeah, he was. Badass motherfucker. I'll tell you that.
More fighters like him.
Nah, we don't have him right now.
We don't have him. What do you think? Why? People are not struggling anymore.
We don't have it anymore. People... See, because right now boxing is so easy. All these fighters are making so much money. All these fighters are picking their opponents. All these fighters are easily, you know, they're fighting guys that they shouldn't be fighting. You know, the big fights are not happening. Let me go see what.
Robert, so let's go back to what we're talking about.
What we're talking about.
That fighters are getting paid a lot right nowadays.
Yeah, they get paid. See, that's why. Right now, fighters got used to getting paid so much against opponents that are not that good. That's why we don't have those type of fighters anymore. You know, Fernando at, what, I don't know, like 21 or 22, was already fighting Yoruboy Campas, Raul Marquez, Icorte. He was like 22 when he fought Trinidad, then De La Hoya. You know what I mean? We don't have that anymore. Right now, it's you know, they select who you're fighting. They build up the fighters to become superstars. Right now, you don't have those type of fighters that are pound for pound because they're beating the best. Look. Chocolatito is one of the best fighters in the world, but he needs to fight Estrada again. He needs to fight Inui, and he needs to give Cuadras the rematch, of course, which he will, but he hasn't yet. We have Triple G, who is also one of the best, but you know, he hasn't moved up in weight, beat up at somebody at 168, hasn't done it, and other guys that he fights in his weight division. Okay. Are just too small for him, or they're not strong enough, so he can't. So is he pound for pound one of the best fighters in the world? Skills wise, yeah, he is pound for pound one of the best fighters, but he hasn't fought that big name. I think Kovalev and Andrew Ward. Now they're fighting the best, so I think the winner deserves to be pound for pound. So that's what I mean, you know. A lot of times they're building up a fighter, Canelo, you know. Canelo's fought a lot of big names, but already, if they're on their way out or he vacated his title to avoid Triple G, so that doesn't look good. So is he one of the best? Yes. But is he fighting the best? I don't think so. He should have fought Triple G. So there's little before we always had all the best fighting the best. That's the way it was before.
What changed in boxing?
They just got business. Before it was a little more about pride. Before the fighters were like, all right, fuck it, I'm getting $5 million, let's sign the contract. Maybe the fight was worth $10 million, but they only got five, but fuck it, they wanted to fight the best. Right now, maybe they get $10 million, but the fight is worth $2 million. And they're still fighting guys that, they're winning millions, fighting guys that shouldn't even be in the ring with them. But who gives a fuck? They're becoming millionaires.
That's true.